Hey, Bobby, there's a lot of stories knocking around out there. Any ones that come to your mind that you want to talk about?
Well, Mike, later on today we have David Kirby on the show, and David Kirby is a journalist and author who's done tremendous work on mercury and vaccines and the impacts of mercury on neurological development of young children. One of the studies that came out this week was very, very disturbing. Researchers have found that many common foods, all of those using commercial high fructose syrup, corn syrup, contain mercury. Right now, I'm drinking a bottle of iced tea, and the second ingredient on it is high fructose corn syrup. And if you look in your grocery store, you'll see that that a high percentage of the foods, barbecue sauce, jam, yogurt, chocolate syrup, almost anything that's sweet has high fructose corn syrup. And as it turns out, in the process of making high fructose corn syrup, they make it in caustic soda that's produced in industrial chlorine plants. And that has a high level of mercury in it. And that mercury has contaminated the high fructose corn syrup. It's not in all of these different
how
products.
How does anybody even know? I mean,
they tested 20 different samples of high fructose corn syrup off grocery store shelves in a variety of products, and they found that 9 of the 20 had very, very elevated levels of mercury. And mercury, you know, even small exposures of mercury, we now know, causes severe developmental disorders like tics, like language delay, speech delay in developing brains of children. And high fructose corn syrup is the stuff that we're feeding to our children and a lot of fruit juices and stuff. So anyway, it's something that mothers should be aware of and fathers who do their shopping for their children to try to avoid that. And hopefully we're going to see some government action, quick government action, to make sure by the FDA to make sure that the mercury is taken out, because there is another process for making mercury from hydrochloric acid and caustic soda that is mercury free.
Yeah.
You can make it.
It's actually
the researchers were given gave a copy of the report to the FDA, and this is still all the Bush dead enders at the FDA and the agency
which
has decided.
Hopefully are on their way out here soon.
Hopefully.
Talking about the food industry, let me run this story. This is an incredible story. It's one of those stories when you read it, you think, no big deal. But if you look at what the Saudis have been doing in the past, they've had, of course, gazillion dollars. They have more money than, all the third world countries combined, basically, is the best way I heard it described one time. But, you know, they've spent the money in the past doing things like building their Mile High Tower, a ski resort out of the dry dust of Dubai. They got into the business of trying to grow Saudi Arabian wheat. You might remember that some 30 years ago out in the desert. Of course, when you have enough money, I guess you can do what you want to do. But now what they've done is they're onto something that if you look at it at first, you say, I don't see where this is a story, but it's a huge story. And what they've started doing is buying something called offshore farms. And what that means is they go to places like Africa, Asia, Latin America, and they produce their food products there. The problem is they're producing the food product not for any other part of the world, but for Saudi Arabia. In other words, they go there, they produce the market, they ship it back, and it's kind of like an offshore farm. Well, what they're doing is they're going into all of these various areas and they're buying up all of the land. I mean, huge farm tracts. And, of course, the people that have been subsistence farmers, they're having to leave the tract. Poor farmers are being forced off productive land as guys with checks kind of show up in town and buy up the land, and they make it into the Saudi Arabian wheat business or the Saudi Arabian corn business or lettuce or whatever it is. So they're basically using the land of all these third world countries not really to put more money into the market of food, and but to put more money and more food into Saudi Arabia.
And it's the old form of colonialism, which was based upon the plan for resource extraction from these various countries. And I've seen this. I just came back from Alberta up in Canada, and I've seen this. This is one of the target areas for the Saudis. They're going up there, buying the wheat fields and trying to make deals with the Canadian government that if they own these wheat fields, the wheat can only be exported to Saudi Arabia. So it's not going to go into the world market to feed the hungry people of the world. It's going to go just directly to Saudi Arabia. And so, and what they do is they're basically, it's an attack on the sovereignty of and the democracy of Canada, which is based upon thousands of farmers owning land and being able to interact in a marketplace. And they're coming in there the same way that the Indonesian company or Japanese or an American company might go to Latin America and say, we are going to take control of your forests and we're going to extract the timber. We're going to take control of your oil. We're going to own the oil and we'll sell it how we want.
Isn't this one of those stories, though, Bobby, that, you know, you've talked about so many times, you read the headlines, you read the first paragraph and you say, you know, I don't know. It doesn't seem like this is a big story. This is a huge story that's gotten very little attention. And that's a big problem.
You know, it's related to we have another story this week, which I think people did raise their eyebrows about, which is that Exxon's, and, you know, talk about colonialism. Exxon is making this year record profits when the oil industry has collapsed. This is the legacy of the Bush administration because they gave these companies so much power and so much advantage in the marketplace. Exxon is making a record $45.2 billion in profits for this year, despite fourth quarter earnings that were slightly lower than expected. The same is true with many of the other
but they
oil
have
companies.
Bobby, they have the PR. I don't know if you've noticed this. They have their PR machine out, almost making it sound like they've fallen on hard times. I don't know if you've caught those. It's incredible.
I feel sorry for them.
Yeah, 45.
You have to
billion.
Feel sorry for them. And then
where are they making the money? Where are they making? They're making it at the pumps, basically, aren't they? Refueling
they're
pumps.
They're making it
refineries.
At the pumps, and they're making it at the refineries, which they, you know, 5 years ago they were saying they couldn't make money at the refineries, but that's what they're doing. And this is an interesting note from the Bush administration. For those of you who were worrying where Gail Norton would be able to get a job after she left the Interior Department, guess what? She's working as Shell's general counsel for oil shale. Now, this again is happening in Alberta. This is the fuel from hell. So Gail Norton has decided
it's the dirtiest of the dirty fuels.
It's the dirtiest, and it's horrific. It really is. It's a nightmare from hell, and she must be very comfortable back in her home in hell.
Yeah, one problem up in Canada. One problem up in Canada right now, and it's huge, is that their governments are in bad, bad financial shape. So these corporations realize that right now, and they are pushing the max with Canadians the same way that they have for U.S. And in the past, Canadians have been very quick to say, you're not going to come in here and ruin my air and ruin my water and do these things. But right now you have a government that is in big, big financial straps. So these corporations are taking advantage of that. You know, interesting thing, this is an important point to that story. At the current buyback of shares that ExxonMobil's taking place with ExxonMobil right now, they're going to be a private company in 11 years. You know how significant that is. I mean, it's extraordinary that they have so much money to buy back their own stock.
Exxon now makes more money than any nation on earth except for the top 16 nations. So it is the top 17th.
$6 million an hour during record profits. They're making $6 million an hour. We have to take a quick commercial break. We're going to be right back. Bobby and I are just talking about that news that sometimes escapes mainstream media for good reason.